The problem that scientists face when they're developing new materials is really time and resources. They would take me 10 to 20 years to get all the testing done, validate the material before it can be brought to market. And you can imagine, by the time this material becomes a reality, the industry might have already moved on. So we have to accelerate this material's discovery process. And we're doing this by using robots and by using AI. Imagine you come to me and you say, hey, I am building application X, and here are my requirements. I need a material. And next day I call you and I say, all right, I have the material available for you. You can see how that can drive innovation in every sector.
To train AI models, we need a lot of data. For that, we need a lot of experiments. So robots can do experiments faster, precisely, and 24/7. We don't have to worry about doing repetitive tasks, and we can focus on problem solving.
We train our AI models using a combination of experimental data, computational data, and we also validate our model by data that we generate using our robotics laboratory. The experimental data we use also comes from 40 years, 50 years worth of data that we have from doing testing at Los Alamos National Laboratory.
When we are synthesizing a new alloy, this is where it starts. This is an arc melter where we put pure elements together and melt them together. And this robot is programmed to do that process by itself.
And this whole loop can be running while I go home, melting new compositions, testing those materials, so that I come back in the morning and I can see how well did we do.
Most of the applications that are in the world right now are limited due to the materials that we have in the world. If we can design better alloys, better metals, we can improve these applications.
For example, there is a need to make lighter armor for our warfighters. Currently, we're kind of tapped in terms of the materials we can use for that. Right now, the armor that goes in the vest tends to be heavy. It slows them down. If we can come up with a material that's lighter, it can not only save lives, but make our warfighters more effective. Another application could be designing materials that can withstand extreme temperatures. So fusion energy is a thing that people are really focused on these days. There are no materials right now that can withstand that hot plasma environment for long times. If we can come up with materials for those applications, that's going to get clean energy. A fully functional AI model is going to reduce the time needed for materials discovery from multiple decades to a week, perhaps. If you can accelerate materials discovery, you can accelerate innovations in national security, in energy. Everything out there uses some kind of material to build an application.